Good afternoon, friends. Myself Anand Patnaik from Mechanical Department. In last lecture, we have seen about some introduction part about mechanical measurement. In that, we have seen what is generalized measurement system. We have seen introduction to mechanical measurement, then significance of mechanical measurement system. Significance is important. Then classification of instrument, then generalized measurement system, generalization of measurement system, then types of input, what are the types of input, then with errors. Then we have seen one example about full wrist strain gauge, half wrist strain gauge, and quarter wrist strain gauge. And in last session, up to static calibration, we have completed our session. Okay, so this session we are starting with static characteristic. Okay. So this session, session 2, in module number 1, we have started with static characteristic. First of all, before going to static characteristic, let us know what is meant by static calibration. Okay? All static performance characteristics are obtained in one form or another by the process called static calibration. Okay? Let us take one example of calibration. Okay? You are going in market. Okay? You are purchasing, let us say 1 kg seeds. Okay, 1 kg seeds you are purchasing from market. That 1 kg seeds you are weighted on some load cell or what you can say that weighing machine. Okay, you are weighing on that machine. That machine will give you accurate 1 kg weight. Okay, that machine will give you accurate 1 kg weight because of that calibration. Because of that calibration, what a manufacturer done, manufacturers have calibrated this machine with the, some standard one. So that same example here, manufacturer have calibrated this machine with some standard one, like 1 kg, 2 kg, 3 kg, 5 kg, and that varies in voltage. Manufacturer have calibrated and compared and added one formula to that machine, and that is known as static calibration, because it will give you some static measurement or static readings. Okay, so in that all types of input, so here in this case, here all types of input are constant. Okay, but I am saying all types of input are constant means we are giving one reading or we are weighting, we are weighing that machine with a constant. Whatever weight we are applying on that machine is a constant. Okay, then it develops input output relationship, so that transfer function of instrument is constant, not different equation, differential equation. Okay, it develops input output relation. In previous lesson, what we learned, that input output relation for any static characteristic function is a constant one. Okay, so that input output relation, whatever that weight and voltage relation is constant, so it develops input output relation, so that transfer function of instrument is constant. Transfer function, it is a what we can say, transfer function means we are converting our voltage or changing voltage into wave. That constant, that coefficient is here as a part of a transfer function. Okay, so in static calibration, that transfer function is a constant one for constant static calibration. Okay, then third point is a calibration opposite to check instrument against known standard. What I said, we are comparing standard one with our instrument. We are comparing standard one, let us say 1 kg, 2 kg, 3 kg, 4 kg, 5 kg, with standard one. Okay? And we are calibrating our instrument. So it offers opportunity to check instrument. Means after calibration, we can also check that weight, whether it is giving correct weight or not. Okay? We have to check. Then also we can sell our product in market without checking or without manipulating or without quality check. We cannot linearity is the function or linearity is a property of instrument. Linearity is a maximum deviation of any calibrated point from straight line. Okay. As I know, static calibration will generate input-output relationship. Okay. Well, let us suppose that at 2 kilovolt at 20 kilovolt the voltage variation is, let us suppose that 2 volt. At 40 kilovolt the voltage variation is 4 volt. At 60 kilovolt voltage variation is 6 volt. Okay, so it develop one straight line. Okay, so it develop one straight line, that is known as input output relationship. Okay, and in actual case it is a idealized straight line. It is an idealized straight line, but in actual case there are some errors in instrument. We have studied many types of error, that is environment error, systematic error, human error, many types of error. In with including that error, the actual cause is different. The actual cause is different from idealized one. The actual cause is different from idealized one. Okay? Here actual curve, here is shown is actual curve, here is an idealized one. Okay? So actual curve is different from idealized one. And that is shown by deviation. You know that deviation, how to calculate deviation? Standard deviation. Okay? So that difference is shown by deviation, and that difference will give you the quality of instrument. Always we are keeping that deviation, to zero. We are trying deviation to zero. We know that there is no measurement which will give you no errors. Remember my sentence, no measurement which will give you no errors. Every measurement have certain errors. Okay. Our aim to minimize errors. Okay? Here we are only minimizing that quantity, maximum deviation. Okay? So output directly proportional to input. Okay? Input output relationship to output directly proportional to input. Okay? Then second property is accuracy of instrument. Okay? Accuracy, the definition of accuracy is the value closest to the true value. Okay? As I told you, weighing instruments will give you some readings, 1 kg, 2 kg, okay? And we are comparing with standard ones, okay? So, closeness to the true value. Let us suppose that it is giving 1.01 kg or 1.0001 kg, okay? So, that is it, closeness to accurate one, to 1 kg. So, the material accuracy we can define as the closeness to the true value. Okay, then precision. It is measure of reproducibility of measurement. It is a measure of reproducibility. Remember this word, reproducibility. Reproducibility depends on the number of readings, number of samples we are taking for same reading. What I am saying, number of samples we are taking for same reading means your many times you are getting reading for, many times you are getting samples for only 1 kg, only 1 reading, and you are reproducing your work, that is known as a precision. Okay? In this diagram you can see, this is the accuracy, this one is the accuracy. Okay, this one is the precision. Okay, when you are targeting with the help of gun, if you target at midpoint, that will show you your precision. Okay, and if you are again and again target somewhere else other than your target, will give you precision. Okay, but precision and accuracy are different terms. There are many differences in between them. Okay? Then reproducibility, closeness of output reading with same input. Reproducibility is closeness of output reading with same input when changed in method of measurement. Reproducibility, as I mentioned, reproducibility in precision. So it will give you same reading with change in method of measurement. Change in method of measurement means what we are doing, we are changing only method of measurement with same instrument, with same readings, with same quantity. Okay, so this is the three diagrams. By three diagrams you can see here is the poor precision and good accuracy. Poor precision, good accuracy. Here is the good precision but poor accuracy. Here is the good precision but poor accuracy. And here good precision and good accuracy. Okay. Then threshold. When input is increased gradually from zero, there will be some minimum value which no output change is detected. Okay. Means as we know, when we are moving on automobile, okay, at start we will we need more torque to gain some velocity. Okay, likewise here we can say threshold with input increase gradually from zero. Okay, there will be some minimum value below which no output is detected. Means here is your x axis, here is the y axis. Okay, you are giving input, but there is no change in output up to certain value. After some value, if you are doing input, there is a change in output value. But for some portion, there is a no change in output value. Okay, this is known as the threshold value. That value is known as the threshold value. Okay, then hysteresis. It is a property of the instrument. It is a non-coincidence between input and output curve. Okay, as you can see in this figure, where this is the input, this is the output. Okay, we are giving input and we are observing parallel output. Okay, and this is the non-coincidence between input and output curve. Okay, we are giving some voltage and we are observing some readings that will give some different curve than output curve. Okay, in many instruments which will give you maximum hysteresis, that are not considered as a standard one. Okay, the hysteresis process should be minimum. Okay, hysteresis process should be minimum. As a strain gauge, we know strain gauge affected by many errors or many environment, many voltage. There are many types of error in strain measurement. So in that case, you can see one example of strain gauge, and hysteresis losses can be observed by strain gauge instrument. Okay. Then next is the drift. There are many types of drifts. Here I am explaining three types of drift. First is the zero drift, second is the span drift, third one is the zonal drift. Okay, so let us suppose that this is a zero drift. Okay, this is a sensitivity drift and this is the idealizing line. Okay, we are giving input and we are observing output. Okay, we are giving input, we are observing output. Okay, so zero drifts means here is a showing, the line is showing zero drifts. Here is a line showing zero drifts. So this line will show you the deflection in reading, deviation in reading from start point. Deviation in reading from start point. Okay, there is a some deviation and the slope of drift line and actual idealized line is same. The slope of drift line and actual idealized line is same. Okay, that known as the zero drift. Then sensitivity drift. This is the sensitivity drift. As you know, gradually increase in drift. Okay, at started point the line is a same. At start point the line is a same. But after some point there is an increase in drift with respect to time. Increase in drift with respect to time is known as a sensitivity drift. Here you can say this drift. Then zonal drift. Zonal drift we can say that drift for particular zone. Zonal drift for particular zone. Let us suppose that there are environmental errors in our instrument and some voltage variation is happening during readings. Okay, some voltage variation are happening during reading. So at that time, for that voltage variation will give you some zonal drift. That is known as a zonal drift.